I've been doing it since I was very small. And for me, there's nothing really like the peace I feel when I'm canoeing on a river at daybreak. And I didn't really understand what made a canoe before, though. It was just something to get me where I was going. But then I started working on this canoe, and I really started to understand the history and what went into a canoe and how really to use it. And I feel really privileged to have been able to take part in this project.
I felt it was a time to share the knowledge that I gained with the kids.
Yeah.
In our culture, it's important not to hoard the information.
Yes.
Okay? Because if I die tomorrow, it's gone.
Right.
We share it. As in this case here, there was 10 kids, so I gave a little bit to every one of those 10 kids. So if they ever want to build a canoe, they have no choice. They have to come together.
Yes.
That's how we build our strong communities. That's how we used to do it. That was the tribal way of doing it, and this is how we need to go back to as well.
Let me ask you something. When they took off in the canoe there, mm-hmm. right at this Riverside Park here in Pembroke, how did you feel to think that you've just been the bridge between your ancestors and a handful of modern day kids in a school here in Pembroke?
Proud.
Yeah.